tons of people came to the site, signed up. Did you see any patterns?
Actually, that was like one of our goals, trying to figure out if our persona was correct. But it was almost impossible to figure out because those 25,000 people are from almost 40 countries. We couldn't get a pick up a pattern from the analytics data that we had, unfortunately.
What did you end up doing then?
That was the big question for us. I mean, what do we do with such a diverse group? But then an interesting thing happened. Out of the hundreds of emails that we received, good and bad, there were like probably up to 10 of them, which were from a different category of people. They were people with terminal diseases who said, we have three, maybe six more months to live. And we really want to get access to this product because we want to keep our stories, our memories. And that was mind-blowing. We didn't expect that. We didn't know what to reply to them.
Marius said, must have been quite an awakening for you. You start with this crazy idea that is so fun in the beginning. And that exercise puts you in contact with people for whom you could say the end is in sight and who have very different perspective.
Yeah, that was mind-blowing. And as I said, at first we couldn't know what to tell them. And we couldn't tell them that, you know, this is an exercise, this is a very early stage idea. So we told them basically, sorry, it's going to take us quite a while to create this product. And the only thing you can do right now is record home videos, keep a diary, spend more time with your family. But on the other hand, this sort of like really encouraged us to build this product because we realized there are some people who really need it. For our initial persona, this was more like a nice to have thing. For these people, it was a painkiller, it was like a must have.
Yeah, so as a result, did you decide to focus on a different persona?
Yeah, actually we realized that those people really need this thing and we talked more to them. And we realized that for them, what's most important is like preserving those stories, those thoughts, those memories in the last months of their lives. My grandmother had Alzheimer's for the last 3 years of her life, and her memories just disappeared. And that was one of the most traumatizing parts for her and for our family. The fact that, you know, she would have those moments of lucidity when she realized that a lot of things were gone. So probably if there was a way for her to record her memories, you know, like videos or other way, before she would be gone, that would have been much more comforting for her and for our family. So I made the connection and I thought, yeah, those people would really see it as something important to collect all their thoughts, stories, memories before, you know, their memory or even themselves are gone.
So did this experience change what you imagined your product to be?
Definitely, but not on in terms of like a long-term vision. The long-term vision is the same, keeping up, you know, as many as stories and thoughts from the current generations for the future. But our initial focus is different. If our initial focus before was like building this crazy AI that would be able to sort of like replicate your personality, your way of talking, now the focus is on collecting data, because that's the first thing that goes away. You know, we can focus on the AI part later, and right now just think of how we can collect more of those thoughts, stories, and memories from people.